The Rotary Club of Lethbridge and the Lethbridge Herald would like to welcome you to the 2014 Lethbridge Citizen of the Year Award.
The Rotary Club of Lethbridge got involved with the Citizen of the Year because we believe that it's important to have a strong community, and we can only have a strong community if we have strong members in our community. And it was really important to us to make sure that those people are recognized, and that's why we partnered with the Lethbridge Herald to 9 years ago to begin this Citizen of the Year.
We had both thought it was long overdue that a city of this size start recognizing some of the citizens who've played such a large role in developing our city. So it was at that point that we launched the initial Citizen of the Year, and we couldn't be prouder to be part of it still 9 years later and certainly into the future.
We have so many impressive past award winners, but also past nominees. And it says so much about Lethbridge. First of all, a lot of people don't know where this community came from and how it was started. And a lot of it was based on volunteer work, committee work, and from the people that actually won this award and have been nominated for this award. So it's almost like a history when you get to see the paperwork and what these people have done. And it's really exciting because we realize that we're not just this new community, but we've been going strong for a lot of years, and it's because of the citizens of Lethbridge.
This year's recipient is Dr. Van Christou, and a better recipient there couldn't be. Perhaps more than anyone shaped the course of the city. So congratulations, Dr. Van Christou. You're the epitome of what a Citizen of the Year should be.
I really think Lethbridge is a very special place, and I've seen many places around the world, and I always come back to thinking that I would rather be here than anywhere else in the world. Photography started for me as a way to sketch for a painting. I started my whole life as a drawer and a painter. I didn't have enough time to block off to do a job the way I wanted to in painting, so I thought I'll do my sketching with photography. Well, I got busier and busier, and the university came along, and things got so busy that I thought that I would go back to painting when I retired. But photography has become so fascinating with the digital revolution that that hasn't happened yet.
He's a thinker, a man of very, very deep thought, an individual with grace, and really one of those people that I think this community is very lucky to have. Van's one of those individuals that at an earlier age where it wasn't the popular thing to do, he stepped up and did some things that were outside the realm of just your life. Your life is your family, your business, your kids, your day-to-day, but then you've got individuals like Van Christou that not only did that, but stepped outside of that and did things for their community.
I started really with the college. I was the first fundraiser for their library at the college before we had a university. It was after I was appointed to the Senate of the University of Calgary when it first started. I thought that the province of Alberta would really benefit by having a third university, an alternative to the multi-universities at Calgary and Edmonton. I feel that education is the most important ingredient to a democratic society. And I think it's that beginning with a family that had those values, my father and my mother, that I automatically felt that this was a place that I really wanted to invest my time and effort into.
The reason why we are as large as we are is because we have this huge student population, and without that amazing university and the work that he did to bring it to Lethbridge, we wouldn't be where we are. So it was really quite amazing. We base our criteria on volunteer work, impact to the community, and leadership. And he just met every single one of those categories.
I'm so pleased that Arthur Erickson did our initial building. I think that was one of the reasons that we attracted so many leading staff, leading professors to the University of Lethbridge. They thought that a university that had that progressive an architect designing their building must be a good place to work. Helen and I and the family traveled to Expo 67, and as we walked around the site, I spotted all these wonderful sculptures and found out that they were all lent to the Expo by the Bronfman family. So I called our president, our first president, Sam Smith, and asked him to set up a meeting with Charles Bronfman. And at that time, I asked him what he planned to do with all the sculptures when the expo was finished. He said, "We have no plans at all." I said, "Well, you know, we have a university, a new university, a centennial university in Lethbridge, and might it not be appropriate to have one of those sculptures on the university?" He said, "Go ahead and pick whichever one you want." So finally picked the Trog, because I thought it would better complement Erickson's horizontal building with the vertical emphasis of the Trog. And that's the way it was chosen. That was the first piece that went into the collection, the university collection, which I was very interested in.
There isn't a day that goes by that he doesn't step into that, you know, into that world of volunteerism and helping his fellow, you know, Southern Albertan. So that's really what I've come to understand of Van de Vee. That's why we nominated Van Christou for Citizen of the Year. I think it's very important we recognize the people that have done that for this community, and there's a lot of them. And they're all very deserving individuals, but I think that that Van is very deserving of the title of Citizen of the Year, Lethbridge.
I've never thought of being myself as a leader. I just am propelled by strong convictions for things that I believe in. Bringing Arthur Erickson to the city was one of my favorite accomplishments. Also, talking the board, the founding board of governors, of which I was a member, into spending money on an art collection at that time was a pretty outrageous request. And to have finally succeeded and won that by just one vote, that the board dedicated half of 1% of the capital expenditure to buying art, was, I think, one of my favorite accomplishments. And the fact that it's grown now into the biggest collection of art in Canada outside of the National Art Gallery.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lethbridge's 2014 Citizen of the Year, Dr. Van Christou.